These meditation strategies are for you if your mind races at a million miles per hour. Despite the fact that I've been meditating for a long time, I still have trouble turning off my mind. Enter my monkey mind, the nagging, agitated thoughts that keep me from achieving mental peace. Even when I set aside time for silence, a tidal wave of anxieties, fears, and, wait, am I preparing chicken or fish for supper tonight? Although the concept of quieting the mind and blissing out in meditation sounds fantastic, for those of us with hyperactive minds, really establishing a meditative state may be a difficult task. You may have come to assume that meditation isn't for you if you're an overthinker. Experts say that even for persons with busy minds, good meditation is feasible. Here are 9 ideas to get you started. Make a timetable that you stick to. When it comes to slowing our mind, practice makes perfect, just like any other excellent habit. Choosing a consistent time of day is an easy way to educate your brain to recognize when it's time to relax. According to psychotherapist Haley Nittich, LCSW, consistent daily practice is a method to see the most mental health benefits from meditation. Of course, this does not imply that you must schedule your meditation practice at 6 a.m. every day. There should be no rules when it comes to meditation. According to Nittich, it should be intuitive and feel pleasant to each individual practitioner. The optimum time to practice is when you're most likely to stick to it. Make a contemplative environment. When you're surrounded by heaps of laundry or 6 feet away from your wailing kid, it's not simple to go into a contemplative state. It's important to consider your physical surroundings, especially in the beginning stages of your meditation practice. Consider creating a dedicated meditation area in your house. It does not need to be large. Perhaps this entails reserving a specific chair, lighting a fragrant candle, or sitting in front of a cherished photograph. You'll start to equate this tranquil area with clearing your mind over time. You'll be able to tap into the peace of a meditative state when you're not at home on your soft cushion as you get more experience. Meditation is as much a practical tool as it is a spiritual instrument, Nittich explains. It has to be portable so we can take it with us everywhere we go. Participate in group meditations. Although meditation may appear to be a very solitary practice, there is unexpected power in crowds. Collective energy is a strong thing, says Candice Feiereth, a Los Angeles-based breathwork and meditation instructor. There's no question meditating with a partner or in a class can intensify your experience. Making meditation a group activity not only helps us break out from our personal mental patterns, but it also gives accountability that we wouldn't get if we did it alone. Stepping into a container with others, I feel, helps draw us out of our heads and into the experience, Feiereth adds. There's also a yearning to be more completely present, knowing that we're a part of something greater than ourselves. Virtually meditating simply entails combining immersive technology into your routine. This can appear to be paradoxical. Isn't it true that meditation is all about unplugging? Please bear with me on this. I've been using a virtual reality headset to help me focus for years, and the results have been incredible. Strapping the large gadget to my face and choosing pictures like as a serene forest or a sunny beach efficiently blocks out all exterior disturbances, allowing me to completely relax. There are other free ways to meditate digitally if a VR headset isn't in your budget. Consider watching a YouTube video of your favorite nature location. Consider yourself surrounded by the splendor of your computer screen. Listen to a recording as you meditate. Keep that YouTube app open for a while longer. Overthinkers may find that pre-recorded guided meditations are the key to contemplative success. Listening to a leading voice gives the brain something to concentrate on, which helps to keep distracting ideas at a bay. Although a guided trip won't completely calm your thoughts, it's just as useful as silent meditation. Guided meditations are really effective in getting all of the advantages that one would seek from meditation, Feiereth explains. Activation of the sympathetic nervous system, anxiety relief, mood enhancement, blood pressure reduction, heart rate reduction, and stress reduction are all part of this. Choose a movie or audio that aligns with your specific goals, such as anxiety relief, improved sleep, or increased attention. There are a plethora of alternatives available online and in meditation applications. First, do some yoga. There's a reason why yoga and meditation are so closely linked. The impact of synchronizing your inhales and exhales with physical motions may be measured in terms of mental attention. According to a 2018 research, yoga that focuses on movement and breath reduces stress levels. A breath-focused exercise, in particular, helped people pay attention for longer periods of time. Adding movement to your meditation can help relieve the strain of feeling like you have to just be throughout it. Many individuals find sitting with an empty mind simply too difficult, Fayerth observes. By combining movement with activities like Tai Chi, yoga, or walking, you may attain many of the same effects without the mental strain. Begin with some breathing exercises. Controlled breathing is a powerful tool for calming the mind. In reality, many meditation techniques are exclusively focused on breathing, with the expectation of mental and emotional benefits. Simply slowing our breath has been shown to have beneficial effects, such as soothing the nervous system and lowering anxiety. Meanwhile, while meditation, paying attention to your breath gives a consistent focus point, which is a pleasant break from distracting ideas. Add music to the mix. Music improves almost everything, including meditation. The appropriate music helps train the brain to be more attentive, according to studies like this one from 2012 Trusted Source and this one from 2007. According to several studies, listening to New Age-style music can actually lower the pulse rate faster than silence. Music or background noise may be a fantastic aid for persons with anxiety or those who are hesitant to begin meditating because of a busy mind, adds Nidich. Whatever you identify with serenity and focus might be your ideal meditation music. Experiment with various music types to see what works best for you. It's important to remember that wandering thoughts are common. Finally, if you're having trouble with monkey mind, it's important to be kind with yourself. Beating oneself up isn't good for the meditative state of mind anyhow. In actuality, racing thoughts are very natural. It's no surprise we're having difficulties with this since we live in a world that constantly stimulates our brain and senses, Fayerth adds. I constantly advise my clients not to be so harsh on themselves and to remember that society is to blame, not them. Besides, your definition of successful meditation may differ significantly from the guru on a mountaintop picture, and that's also okay. What meditation looks like needs to be normalized, adds Nidich. It's not about sitting in a certain position with your hands up and your thoughts blank. During a time of focused practice, meditation is gaining a momentary sensation of serenity and stillness wherever you may be. Take away even if your mind races, meditation may be an accessible technique of relaxation, centering, and self-exploration. You could just uncover the perfect meditation approach for you with a few easy modifications.